Nithyananda. Hi, this is my Nitya Ovyananda. Thanks again for tuning in. By the grace of His Holiness Paramahamsa Nithyananda, I am again speaking to you about the vows of sannyasi. We are on the fourth vow now. In no particular order I'm doing these, but the fourth vow is Satya, which is truthfulness, honesty, integrity. These are very important vows. Because with honesty, you know, there's really nothing to hide, right? There's nothing to hide of who you are. One of the things is, as a sannyasi, we always say that there's nothing to hide, that there's nothing secret that we keep anymore. So whether it's something that we own, we should share it. If it's something that we want to use, we should share it with others. And especially, same thing with our thoughts or our incompletions that we carry. Or instead of holding it inside, we should share it and reveal it to somebody. Speak it out and be rid of it, complete with it. There's nothing to hide any longer. There's nothing to keep inside. Everything's an open page. Because we are one with the cosmos. We are the cosmos. We're not these incomplete thought currents and patterns and things that we carry around that we feel we need to hide. Oh my God, if anyone knows that about me, I'll die. You know? It's not true. It's not true. And if anyone's judging you that way, well, that's their problem. And when you feel that way, when you feel, you know what, I don't have anything to hide, and if somebody calls me out on something now, you know, before it used to be more difficult because you want to protect your identity. Oh no, I'm not like that. You know, and so you try to hide and you argue. But the more awareness I have when I'm doing that, you know, like yesterday something happened. I went to a little like powerless mode because we were just pulling around all this luggage. And we were just schlepping it around and throwing it on these buses, and my knee's hurting me. I have something going on with my knee. And so, like, just getting in, the whole process of getting into these buses and switching buses, I got a little cranky with somebody. And they're like, the way you're saying that's kind of mean or this or that. I'm like, no, I'm not meaning it like that, you know. So I was trying to cover up that. And then I thought about it for a moment. I'm like, you know what? I said, you know what? I'm completing with you. Like, after 5-10 minutes, I said, I'm not being authentic. I said, you know what, I was feeling powerless because of the situation, and so I was acting kind of like a little baby, and I was being rude, and I'm completing with you on that. So when you come clean and you just be honest, you know, it's such a liberating experience because you're not trying to have all this energy, wasting energy, not trying to hide something or lie about something or cover something up. If you're being a jerk at the moment, you're being a jerk. Just admit it. And then once you admit it, you'll realize it's actually, what a relief. I'm admitting I'm being a jerk, and your whole heart and everything's opening up. And you actually feel more comfortable and confident. Like, you feel lighter because you're not trying to keep something in and then have some incompletion, and not only with yourself, but other people, you know? Because they're obviously seeing something's going on and you're not admitting it, that you're keeping it inside. It just doesn't do any good. So having integrity with yourself and with others and the words you're giving, not only the words, but how you're giving those words and what's going on inside you. Because you can say the same thing in different ways, right? If you're incomplete and you're saying, I don't want any, you know, or let's say like that, or oh thanks, I don't want any, you know, there's different ways you can say something. Well, tell what's going on inside you. So if you're saying one thing in a cranky way, you're obviously in an incomplete thing, and you're, you know, then you're not being integrated if you're lying about it. Anyway, I just wanted to express that a little bit about honesty and satya. And what the beautiful thing is, as being part of the Nithyananda order, and also an Adinavasi, and part of Nithyananda Sangha even, it is our job to uplift each other, to help each other through those times when we're having those moments. And not like, what's the word, coddled people's incompletions. So if somebody's being a jerk, oh, it's okay, baby, give them a hug or something. No. You're going to call them out on it because they need to be rid of those things. And you don't want to support that because there's no reason to support it and perpetuate that mood. Call them out on it. Show them. That's what integrity is. And that's what the beauty is of having that spiritual community, because you then don't fall in on it. If I didn't get continuously hammered, you know, with incompletions and being authentic and being having integrity, I would never realize that I'm continuously trying to defend some fake identity and being right all the time. That's just the ego. When I can admit that and be honest about it, have that space of satya, it's actually a lot better for me also. It's actually that experience of being light and free. More freedom is happening inside. So having the community around to help you and support you. And of course, it's actually a beautiful thing, because if you do decide you need to talk to somebody, say, hey, I'm having this thing that's in completion. You know, speak to somebody that you can trust, somebody that's always going to support you and always keep you aligned with Swamiji, or keep you aligned to the higher self. That's the kind of person you want to speak to, not someone who's going to, you know, caress your incompletion and tell you it's okay, because it's not okay. You need to complete with it to move into more higher spaces and to open up more to the universe. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this next session. We have one more vow, the fifth vow, to speak about, and we'll do that over the next couple of days. Thanks again for watching. Nithyananda.